Hello, what's up, everybody? Gordon Attard here. Welcome to yet another episode, episode number 55. And welcome to you, my friends, who are tuning in right now, maybe live, maybe watching this on a replay. So we're going to bring you another topic today about personal branding, how to build a personal brand for creating your audience, number one, and also creating your business. So if you're tuning in right now, let me know in the comments below where you're coming from. So see where you're tuning in from. Now that we've got some new friends tuning in from US especially, and also in several other countries. So personal branding, it is an interesting topic, isn't it? So most people aren't doing it is because they're afraid of starting, or they have no idea where to begin, just like I was when I first started working on my brand. And it's kind of started my journey on personal branding. So it's a free topic talk today, right, about personal branding. So I'm gonna share with you some things that that helped me out and worked for me, and hopefully it encourages you, and it will put you in a position to start working on your personal brand. And why I love this topic so much is because what it gave me, and what there's no limits, no cap limits on how or where you can go with this. It's unbelievable. I mean, it brought me to a position to be interviewed, to be featured in websites, other websites, and stuff like that. And it's just the beginning. So kudos to you. If you're working on your brand, type in number one, the comment below. It doesn't matter what you're doing. I can give you a quick shout out. Just before we can get started, let me just see if it's everything okay with the audio and stuff like that. You know the drill. Let's see. All right. Awesome. What's up, Sam? Good to see you, my friend. What's up, Sebastian? What's up, Vivalostan? Kenya in the house. Nice. Awesome, my friend. Good to see you here. Okay, so as I said, this is something that if you are building a business, if you're building any kind of business, really, if you're in real estate, if you are in any kind of business, you've got to really come up with a strategy. Some people, they don't know where to start. I understand that, because I was in your shoes. But a lot of people are trying to do it in the wrong way, because they don't have someone that is showing them or have shown them what to do. That's number one big mistake. So do not do that mistake. If you're trying and trying and trying for many months, many years without having traction, without having anything, you know, any audience growth or any business growth, you might be doing something wrong, don't you? Right? So you've got to be clever, smart, to reach out to somebody that can help you, because what you're doing is you're wasting time, because you're trying different things all the time without having any end result. And this is when I see a lot of people doing this. I see a lot of people trying to do something, then they quit what they're doing, and then they do something again with something else, and they quit. There's no consistency in that. So you probably know someone that needs this. Tag them in the comments below. Share this with them, because this might help somebody maybe that you know of, that they had this question. They are trying to build their own business. They are trying to grow an organization without knowing where to start. You see, it's kind of the same thing, you know, when you start doing videos. A lot of people are afraid of switching on the camera, click on the record button and just do a video, because they don't know where what to say. They don't know. They're not knowledgeable. They say whatever it is the case. But this is, if you see the early videos that I did, and I believe if you do videos, that like Sebastian, my buddy here from Germany, do videos, like live videos and stuff like that. Nowadays, also speaking in front of hundreds of people in his business. He started, okay? We started. We just clicked the goddamn button, and we just shared what we know, shared what we have learned, shared what we are applying, what worked, etc., etc. So number one thing is that nowadays it's not even enough being on one platform. Okay, before it could be great, but now you have to spread your wings. Why? Because like these kind of videos that I do, this Facebook Live that I do every Wednesday, I put them in two different platforms. I put them on Facebook. This is why it's recorded. Then I download this and I put it on another different platform, which has a different target, different reach, which is on my YouTube channel. And by the way, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, shame on you. No, just kidding. Just go on YouTube, type in my name and subscribe there. There's other kind of videos in there that I put on a weekly basis. So again, why and why you should be on a different platform is because you cannot get stuck on just building one platform and not having the opportunity to use like Instagram, use like YouTube, okay, which are huge, that you can document what you're doing. Some people tend to think like personal branding, that they need to spend a lot of money and a lot of time, which isn't. I mean, you can be just documenting your day and you just put it on YouTube or put it in a video. If you don't know how to do it, get somebody else. This is what people get stuck. They say, oh, I don't know how to edit. How can I do the video? A lot of people send me, what app did you use, you know, for your stories, for that video? It's something that I'm self-taught because I really wanted to do it and it's fun. For me, it's fun. But sometimes, okay, in some things, I get somebody else to do it for me. I outsource, okay? So I outsource certain things as well, which will take time, and I don't want to waste time on that. So that could be a next step for you. But again, decide which platforms you're gonna put effort and to create audience. And why it's called personal branding? Let's go with that. Personal branding, you've got to personal brand you. Not the shop, not your company, not anything else, is you. Why? Because people, like you guys are tuning in from all over the world, watching this, are sharing this, talking with people, because I want to build relationship with you. And business is all about relationships. So again, some people aren't gonna like this, but I'm okay with this. You know, if Shakira or whatever it is, okay, favorite singer of yours are gonna be all loved from all over the world, it doesn't work like that. Because okay, everyone has people who will jump on and talk dirty or talk different, okay, let's put it that way, talk negative and stuff. It's normal. It's how you react to that. That is very, very important. So don't let that get into your head, okay? Because a lot of people, this is why they don't start on working on their personal brand. So as I said earlier, I was going to share with you some things that helped me when I started to really understand why having a personal brand. So I started with a website. So I bought my domain, gordonattar.com. I didn't know how to do a website, didn't know anything, but I knew that people always told me, okay, my mentors, that I used to go like on a webinar, like 3 a.m. in the morning here where I live, or 4 a.m. in the morning to webinar in US. So I started to follow people. I started to learn and apply. So I bought the domain, I figured out and I learned how to do certain things on a website. Sometimes I ask help and they help me. So then finally I had a website. And in my opinion, I always tell people, you've got to have your own website. You've got to have your website, because if Facebook like few weeks ago shuts down or something happens, we don't know. You don't control it. So imagine if you just build on Facebook and in 1 second, split second, it turns into a nightmare for you. Okay. What would you do? So I always encourage people, get a website. Your website is credibility. Your website is where people find more about you. In fact, I can tell you, since I have my website, the number one page that people will, because it's all about data and statistics, right? So I've learned that the most viewed page on my website, guess what? Is the About Me page. People want to know who you are, where you have been, why you decided to do what you do and stuff like that. What's your mission and what's your story? This is what excites people to start that connection, to start that interest, to see if they can collaborate with you, if they can work with you, if they can start follow you, okay, clicking that button and become your friends. Like I posted earlier, a couple of days ago on Facebook, strangers are just friends you haven't met. You haven't introduced yourself and said, hi, my name is Gordon, what's your name? Pleased to meet you. No. So this is very, very important thing that I've learned. And when it comes to then videos, I started a YouTube channel, which attached with my website, and then Facebook, came along. So I started to learn, okay, always be in on student mode and learn from people out there and apply. Sometimes things that don't work, you need to ditch them and keep what's working until you find your own path, okay, and your own strategy to build your business. You see, you have to differentiate yourself. Nobody's doing what I'm doing from where I am, for sure. Why? Because I learned as much as I could, and I keep learning to tweak little things that keeps me going. So one video, imagine, just when it comes to YouTube, okay, this is something that how it blows up. And I started this when I still was working as a chef. I had a food blog. Few people knew about this. I had a food blog, which, I mean, had people. This is where I saw how this thing can be big, because people from Australia, people from India, people from France, I didn't know who these people are. They were watching and doing my recipes and commenting and stuff like that. So then then when I got into having my own business, I applied the same thing. I got my own website, as I said, especially also YouTube channel. In fact, I have a video. I don't know if you have watched any of my videos, but I have a video that literally went viral. I mean, viral, over 19 million views. This is not video that I'm in, but it's a video that I have on my channel. And you can see it's an inspirational video. It's called the Never Give Up Race. You can go and check it out on YouTube. And how it blew up. Somebody shared it. And if you follow Shark Tank, I don't know if you follow Shark Tank. If you do, type in number two, okay? If you follow Shark Tank. So Barbara Cochran, one of the Sharkettes, okay, if you call it, she shared the video, okay? This is one of the celebrities that shared the video, because you cannot go to 19 million with non-celebrities or people who have a big following. So Barbara Cochran shared the video, okay, with her Twitter followers. I think I have a screenshot somewhere in my folders. And this started to blow up. I mean, people are commenting every single day, being inspired with this video. I have emails coming in from schools with this video. It's like went mental. In fact, I would love to do a video how this impacted many people, and they will definitely do that in a second. But this was just one-offs. Okay, you don't do a video, go viral, and you just wait for everything to grow. So you need to be consistent in creating content. And content can be created two ways. Either you document your life or you create content with the notes that you have, with the knowledge that you gain on a daily basis when you talk with people, when you hang around with people who are better than you. And this is how you start creating content. And again, do not let that limit. Okay, there is no limit how many things you can do. It's people get lost on how many things or the scripts and stuff like that. Okay, just be yourself. People like being yourself. If you make a mistake, it's okay. People do mistakes, and just focus on how can I serve people? How can I help people with a content piece, with a video, with a podcast? There's podcasts that are blowing up every single day. Why don't you have one, okay, which can be another way how you can gain, and maybe then that will lead you to interviews. So what happened to me when I started blogging and I started focusing on personal branding on Facebook? So as you can see, you never know, okay, few people know if you're not in the same company, you don't know what I do if you don't ask. In fact, the most common question that I get is, what do you do? I want to know more, what do you do? You see, it's because I don't focus on promoting my company. I focus on promoting myself. And this is what you should do. Okay? This is what you should do. You should focus on giving out and focusing on personal branding. So your personal brand. It's not your company or maybe the shop that you're working in. Okay? You can be working in a shop. This is a good idea. If you're working in a shop or you know somebody who's working in a shop. Okay? So you've got to promote let's say that you are in real estate. Okay, let's pick up real estate. So it's not your company, you work with a real estate company. How are you differentiating yourself with somebody else? Okay, what do you do? If you just take pictures like every single real estate agent and just put your phone number, like the typical way how you promote and you get the pricing, you're not differentiating yourself. Are you going when you go to do a viewing, get a camera, record, okay? Okay, then you give some tips on the camera. Tell what people should look at if it's their first purchase, their first home that they are purchasing. See, this is what gets you people, more people that start to follow you, and next time you start receiving calls that they want your help to get their own place. They want your help to get their own new apartment, whatever it is. So you can do it with anything. If you sell vegetables, whatever it is, what is that you're doing? If you're just telling people that you're open from Monday till Sunday and from 9 a.m. till 8 p.m., it's like everybody else. What are you doing different? So this is why I'm excited about this topic. And I always tell people they need to dedicate time, put in a strategy or game plan. If you don't know, you can reach out to me. Okay. You can message me and I can help you with that. If you're serious about that. So, or start following other people and see what other people are doing. Okay. So this also something that can help you. Facebook lives, videos are important nowadays. People want to see you, not to just read about you. People want to see you, see how you talk, what's your attitude and stuff like that. So that's also a big, very good, okay, big tick and checkpoint that I highly suggest you to do if you are looking to grow your audience and grow your business. Because again, people do business with people, not with just companies, but people are looking to join people who have a mission, who have a purpose. So you can read the purpose on my Facebook page, right? So that's what I stand for, okay? And that's where we're heading. So no matter what's happening, it's because you have a clear vision. When you have a clear vision, like you have a clear vision for your personal brand. So what is your personal brand? What do you want it? Let me know in the comments below. What is that you want to happen with your personal brand? Are you just posting things from your company or posting things that doesn't matter on your Facebook? Because a lot of people, you don't know if they have a business or not because they don't show it, okay? And you need to show what you're doing in a general way. Again, whatever it is that you're doing, you've got to do that. If you don't want to create your content with the notes or with the, maybe you saw a video that you, or maybe you read a book, okay, this is also something that I started with. I read a book and I picked up six things and I shared it with them. Okay, so again, this is very, very important. Do not focus on what if nobody is gonna see my video. What if I'm gonna suck at this? Because everybody that started hitting that record button started from somewhere and there was nobody. So you've got to focus on how many times are you going to hit that button? What is your strategy to start sharing content? And share content about what you're doing, about what you're good at, okay? So if it's a business that you're building, you probably went to some events, right? Probably you wrote notes at that event. Am I right? So where are those notes? What are you doing with those notes? If you have been to an event like 3 years ago, get those notes out of your drawer, out of your shelf, whatever it is that you store them. That's your content, my friends. That's your content. Okay? Three things about this. How to about this. Okay? This is what can help you start giving information. Some people are clueless about what type of content they can share. And I just give you a great tip here. Turn your notes into content. Okay. Go to events. That's where you can document as well your journey, but tell people what you have learned at that event from that kind of person. If you read a book, if you watched a video. So this is something that definitely will help you out. So let me see if there's, what's up, Shaheen, in the house? Thank you, True 12, always be student. I don't know about your food blog. I had a food blog, Shaheen. I don't post anything. I think it's off right now. So it was called, guess what? pimpthatfood.com. So tell you one story, quick story about that food blog. That food blog got me on three magazines. Okay, that food blog got me on three magazines that I did recipes on, and I negotiated to have my link. Okay, I didn't pay anything because I just focused on content. I told them, I'm gonna give you content. I'm not gonna charge you to feature me and stuff like that. All I want is my link. Okay, so that's when it started to happen, and it's all about because one simple action. It was in 2009 when I had that food blog. So quite a long time ago. So okay, London in the house. We've got Nigeria in the house. Philippines, my friends from the Philippines. I need to visit Philippines. Okay, so that's what it's all about. And last thing is engaging. Okay, you've got to engage with people on a different level that people are doing. I mean, just to mention one little thing, I tried something in a group that there's like, I don't know how many thousands of people in this group, which is in my niche, okay, in home building business from home. So I gave value. I asked them, look, okay, listen to this. I asked them, look, I have a list, okay? I have a list of self-development documentaries that can change your life. If you want this list, type in the comment below, okay? And I will send it to you via Messenger. I mean, I cannot keep up. Just tell you this. Over 209 comments. It blew up this post, okay? Over 209 comments. And I cannot message them all at once because Facebook, you know how it works. If you message Facebook the same with the link and stuff, over 25, I believe, they will put you in Facebook jail. So just to give you an idea, this is something I gave them value. I don't know these people, but I'm gonna drive them to my website. This is what I'm doing. I'm driving them to my website. Some people will click on something else. Some people will see who's this guy? Click on the About Me page. Some people is entering in my list and stuff like that. And somebody will purchase some things that I have on my blog. Just by one action, I focused on giving them value. So some I'm building relationship with, I'm engaging with them. So every comment I'm replying, when I send them, I'm replying, not just like people, you know, send them and that's it. I want to create that relationship. And this is what will also increase your audience when it comes to how soon and how fast and how quick are you engaging with new people that you don't know, that you haven't met, but eventually they can become friends. You have strong relationship. You can collaborate with them. Maybe they can interview on the next Facebook Live like we sometimes do as well. So hopefully these kind of tips that I shared with you on this topic today, how to create a personal brand, okay, your personal branding, and also that will help you to increase your audience and increase your business at the end of the day, because that's what it's all about as well. So if you have, if you like this topic, if you like this so far, let me know. Click on the hearts button, share this around. If you're watching the replay, hashtag replay down the comments below. I want to see where you are tuning in. So I love to see my international fam in here. And if you want to know more, okay, about personal branding, you can reach out to me, direct message me, and I can help you with it as well. Let me see how can I help you with that. And also, I'm going to put this on my YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/GordonAttard. You can find these and the rest of other episodes so you don't miss them on my YouTube channel as well. We're closing to 7,000 subscribers, so a little push to hit that as well. And if you want more trainings like this, free more trainings like this, you can go on GordonAttard.com. That's GordonAttard.com. For more free trainings like this. Having said that, I wish you a pleasant rest of the day, wherever you're watching us, a pleasant evening if you are in Europe, and a great afternoon if you are in US, and I'll see you on the next episode of the G Show. Having said that, have a great day, my friends, and have a great rest of the week. Bye-bye, take care, God bless.